this magic moment.
Everybody kept saying when we were out there, you got to go to the San Diego Zoo. That's the greatest zoo in the world. And we went, and that's bullshit. Too much walking. The animals are too goddamn far apart. I told my wife, I said, I need to make it more exciting. You know, take a Slim Jim, stick it in the ass of a death row inmate, have him run through that lion cage without getting bit. See if he can make it. I'd enjoy the shit out of that. There he goes. Shit, did you see that shit? The fucker almost got bit. That was fun. Then if he eats a Slim Jim, we'll give him a free pack of cigarettes. Oh, hell, he's eating it. Come on, kids. I joined a gym while I was out there, too. And I don't particularly care to work out, but I certainly enjoy seeing them girls in that yoga class. Good God, are they talented. They had one woman in there who could have licked her own vagina. If she would have just listened to me, I swear to God. You can do it, baby. Come on now. Come on. Get that. You want me to put my foot on your back? You want me to get down there and do it for you? It looks delicious. I'll split it with you. Oh, hell. And they got this guy that trains everybody to box, and his name's Roy. And Roy's a big son of a bitch. He's like 6'2", like me, you know. And he said to me, Rodney, you ever think about boxing? Because you're thick, boy. You look like you whoop hell out of somebody. I said, Roy, I've never lost a fight in my life because I'm quick. Gone. Feel like some shit's about to happen, and where's Rodney? He must be hiding. Or I just take my pants off because nobody wants to fight a naked guy. Oh, you want some? You can scare a big son of a bitch with a little pecker. What I thought. Roy tells me every day I come in the gym, he's like, what's up, champ? Rodney, you're the champ. He's introducing me to people. Y'all meet the champ. 3 weeks of this shit goes on, people are calling me the champ in the gym. Everybody knows me as the champ. And somehow, in my mind, this just starts building confidence, that, you know, creating some sort of fantasy that maybe I'm the champ. You know, I start really thinking that maybe I am like a, you know, I'm laying in bed with my wife at night going, maybe I'm a bad motherfucker and I don't even know it. She said, you're going to get your ass whipped, what you're going to do. Well, I get in the ring with Roy 3 days later. He talks me into it. I got the headgear on. You know the headgear where your nose pokes out just far enough to get the shit knocked out of it? Well, I was wearing that and Roy didn't know it, but up underneath them big red gloves, bing, had them middle knuckles up. I was about to frog the shit out of Roy. He says, I want you to get used to hitting a moving target. I said, okay. He comes bouncing in there and right in the forehead. I popped him. He said, damn, that's good. He says, now I'm fixing to start hitting you. And I said something really stupid, like, bring it on, motherfucker. And he did. He hit me in the ear, just, ow, God, time out. My ear's hot. Fucker's red too. Is it red? Is that all you got, hitting people in the ear and shit like that? And it wasn't. He had more. He hit me in the nose like 9 more times. I counted. Just, you know, when you get hit in the nose, your eyes start watering. It looks like you're crying. But at that point, I realized that I was crying. I said, fuck you. I quit. I think I peed. Shit. That was the end of my boxing career.